Hello students, welcome to your software engineering class. In the previous session, I have discussed about the user interface design and the characteristic of a good user interface. In this session, I will discuss about the basic concept of user interface design. After completion of this video class, you will able to know about the basic concept like online help, system guidance message, and error message, and the difference between mode-based and modeless interface, and difference between graphical user interface and text-based user interface. So let's start. The contents of this video are basic concept. In basic concept, I will discuss about online help system, guidance message, and error message, and then the difference between mode-based and modeless interface, graphical user interface versus text-based user interface. So let's start. First of all, when a user interact to the software, it interact through user interface. When a user interact the software through the interface, he may need some guidance or he may seek help from the system. And the user guidance is provided through two broad categories. First one is online help system, and second one is guidance and error message produced in response to the user actions. Means he may require some help that can be given through the online help system, or guidance and error message according to the action of the user. These are the characteristic, basic characteristic of a good user interface. Actually, the generic help are not so useful, but the online help message should be tailored to the context in which help is invoked. Means the online help system may be useful for the user, what he wants to do in the software. He can know the exact requirement of the online help system, may know the exact requirement, exact help needed by the user. A good online help should provide message in context depend way. Keep track of what a user is doing. Help messages should be tailored to user experience level. Should take advantage of graphics capability of screen, not just by copy the user manual. Means a online help system know what the user is doing on the software, and on the basis of the requirement of the user helping, the online help should provide the suggestion to the user. And it can use graphical method to explain the user the steps, and it is not a just copy of the user manual. It can show the detail how the user can use the software. The next is guidance message. Guidance message means it prompts the user what to do when. After this step, what will be the next step? This is the guidance message. The guidance message should be carefully designed, prompt the user next action he or she might take. Means what is the next step after this step? The guidance message may be prompted by the software interface to guide the user. Current status of the system, progress made so far in processing the command. I mean, while processing also we can show the message that processing is continue, and the current status and what are the next step to do by the user. We can prompt the user to guide to use the software. So these are the guidance message which can provided to the user. And these are the characteristic of a good user interface. In a good user interface, we provide the online help system and guidance message. A good guidance system should have different level of sophistication for different category of user. User should have an option to turn off detailed message. Means the guidance message are of different level for different level of user. If the user is experienced, he need a short message, and if the user is novice, new user, then he need the detailed message. So the message can turn on or turn off for detailed message for different type of user. Then the next is error message. Error message should be polite. Error message should not be associated with noise, might embarrass the user. Means error messages are should be of a in a polite language, and error message should not be associated with the sound because it might embarrass the user. The message should suggest how a given error can be rectified. Means how to rectify the message, that also be in the error message. If appropriate, the user should be given the option of invoking online help. Means in error message, there may be an option to use online help for the user to find out more about the error situation, and he can get the situation of error and how to rectify it, how to prevent the error. It can be given in the online help system. And from the error message, he can go to the online help system also. This is the example of an improper error message. Okay, the error message should not be so loud, or it will always, the error message should be in a polite word. The next is mode-based and modeless interface. A mode each state or collection of states. In each state or mode, different types of command are available. Means in a mode that is a state, there are many commands available in a state, or in different mode there may be same command or different set of command. If there are same command in different state, then it is known as modeless. Modeless interface, same set of commands are available at all time, at all the state, at all the mode, there are same set of command. And mode based interface means different set of command are available depending on the mode. In different mode, there may be different command which the system is. Okay, means there are different set of command in different mode based on the post sequence of the user command. So modeless means same set of command in different mode, but in mode based, there are different command in different state based on the sequence of the user command. A mode-based interface can be representing using a state transition diagram. Each mode of the state transition diagram represent a mode, and every state or node of the diagram annotated with command name meaningful in the state. Means in mode-based interface, there are many commands in different modes. So it can be represented through state transition diagram, and each state of the state transition diagram represent a mode, and every mode of the diagram have different command with meaningful names in that state. Then the next is the difference between graphical user interface and text-based user interface. In a GUI, several windows with different information can be simultaneously displayed on the user screen. As we know, in GUI, we can open different windows simultaneously and work on different windows. This is perhaps the biggest advantage of GUI. User can simultaneously interact with several related items at any time, can even run many unrelated applications, and also can run many applications, unrelated applications. This is the main advantage of GUI, and GUI attract the user because it is attractive and it can provide simultaneously work with several items in different window, and it can run many unrelated items also. But in text base, we can run only one item at a time. Iconic information representation and symbolic information manipulation is possible in GUI. Means in GUI, all things can be represented through different icon. And the symbolic information is very attractive and easy to understand and easy to learn. Symbolic information manipulation, such as pulling an icon representing a file into trash can for deleting. Means pulling icon can be displayed to delete a file. Intuitively very appealing. User can instantly remember it. Means the representation of icon can very appealing and easy to understand to the user. In GUI, the user can easily understand, easily recall, and he don't have to memorize the syntax and semantics of any command. Easily use the software. A GUI can support command selection using an attractive and user-friendly menu selection system. In a GUI, a pointing device can be used, a mouse or a light pen, to issue command. The use of a pointing device makes command issue procedure simpler. Means, as we know, GUI support command selection using an attractive and user-friendly menus. Means through menus based, the GUI can support different command. And in GUI, we can use any pointing device like light pen, mouse, joystick, that can help to select the command or to issue a command. Okay. On the flip side, a GUI requires special terminals with graphical capability, requires special input device such as mouse. Means these are the things required for GUI software. Means in text base, we need not use any pointing device, but the GUI is better than an attractive and useful for the user as compared to text-based interface. In contrast, a text-based interface can run even on cheap alphanumeric terminals. Graphical terminals are usually much more expensive than alphanumeric terminal. Means the text-based interface is very cheap and can easily available, and the graphical terminal are more expensive. Increasing availability of terminals with graphics capability, bitmap, high resolution display, significant amount of local processing power. means today we using a terminals with graphical capability and with high resolution and significant amount of local processing power encourage us to support the graphical user interface. So we will concentrate our attention to GUI. So in the basis of these things, we can use GUI mostly in all software as compared to text-based. Okay, so in this session I have discussed about different basic concepts like online help system, error message and guidance message for a good software interface, and the difference between GUI interface and text-based interface. Actually nowadays all the developer use GUI for easy and user-friendly interface. Thank you.